السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, جزاكم الله خيرا for tuning into this message. You know, a little over a week ago, we witnessed the conclusion of the 2010 World Cup. Players came from all across the world with one goal in mind, to become world champions. But at the end of the day, we gotta be honest with ourselves. It was just a game. But now, we are only about 3 weeks away from the real competition. I'm talking about the competition to free ourselves and our necks from the hellfire. I'm talking about the competition for Jannah. I'm talking about Ramadan 2010. And I want to ask you, my dear brother and my dear sister, are you ready for this year's competition? Or are you gonna do like you did with the World Cup and just basically watch? You see, my dear brothers and sisters, in order for these players to compete in the World Cup, they practiced and practiced and practiced and practiced for months and even years. And at the same time, in order for me and you to compete in this year's competition in Ramadan, we have to practice. And that is why we have this beautiful month of Sha'ban, in order for us to practice. In order for us to practice salah, in order for us to practice fasting, in order for us to practice sadaqah, and to practice every type of good deed that we can, so that when Ramadan starts, we're ready. We're ready for the competition. So, here are 10 tips to work on this month before Ramadan, so that you can be literally in shape, inshallah, when this amazing month comes in, inshallah. The first tip is salah. You see, my dear brothers and sisters, there is nothing that you can do that is better and that is more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than to improve on and to perfect the fara'id, which are the compulsory acts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to do. And from those fara'id, from those compulsory acts, there is nothing better and more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you can improve on and do than salah. You see, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said to him, أَيُّ الْعَمَلْ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ. What action is most beloved to Allah? So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الصَّلَاةُ عَلَى وَقْتِهَا. Salah at its prescribed times. So the number one tip is, try to improve on and perfect the five daily salah, which includes Salatul Fajr, by the way, which many of us miss. And try to have as much khushu' as possible in your salah. And at the same time, maybe try to pray two rak'ahs at night, maybe after Isha, or wake up 15 minutes before Fajr and pray two rak'ahs of Qiyam, so that you can get ready inshallah for Ramadan when we start praying Taraweeh. The second tip revolves around the Qur'an. The Qur'an. See, my dear brothers and sisters, we have left the Qur'an almost for the past year. If you ask some of us, when was the last time that you actually picked up the Qur'an and you started reading from it, they may actually tell you last Ramadan, which is very sad. But we're here to improve on ourselves, inshallah. So, what you can do is try to read at least some Qur'an every single day. It could be one page, it could be five ayahs, whatever you can do. But try to make it constant for the next 3 weeks, inshallah, and go ahead and read some Qur'an. And if you can't read Qur'an in Arabic, then go ahead and read the translation. And if you can't do that, then at least listen to some Qur'an, inshallah. Just go on YouTube and put Qur'an and you'll have tons of surahs that come up in beautiful voices and beautiful recitations, inshallah. The third thing, and it is very, very important, is tawbah. Tawbah. Repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, my dear brothers and sisters, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, كُلُّ بْنِ آدَمَ خَطَّاءُ وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. All of Bani Adam, all of the sons and the daughters of Adam are sinners. And the best of those sinners are those who repent. You know, there's that one sin that you do that you keep on doing over and over and over and over again. And there is this one sin that I do, and that I keep doing over and over and over and over again. I don't know your sin, and you don't know my sin, but I do know that it's there. So go ahead and repent right now and say, Atubu ila Allah. Atubu ila Allah. I repent to Allah. I repent to Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all your sins. And to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it takes three easy steps. The first step is you have to stop doing the sin. The second step is you have to feel bad about it. And the third step is you have to make a vow to yourself and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you will never return back to that sin. And if you return back to it, then make tawbah once again. And if you return back to it, then make tawbah again. And if you return back to it, then keep on making tawbah and tawbah and tawbah all over again. And every time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sin. The fourth tip is righteous friendship. You have to realize, my dear brother and my dear sister, that you cannot go into Ramadan this year alone. You can't. You're not going to be able to do it alone. And if you think, you know, you're all big or something, look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said to him in Surah Al-Kahf, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيِّ. And make yourself patient with those who call on their Lord day and night. So, my dear brothers and sisters, find someone. Find brothers, find a brother, sisters, find a sister, a husband and wife, they can work together and say, inshallah, we're going to practice for these next 3 weeks together. And inshallah, we're going to go on to Ramadan 2010 together. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala free our necks from the hellfire together, inshallah. Number five is fasting. In order to be able to fast correctly in Ramadan, you have to do some practice. It's common sense. So go ahead and try to fast as much as you can in Sha'ban. And remember this amazing hadith. Prophet ﷺ says, مَنْ صَامَ يَوْمًا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بَاعَدَ اللَّهُ وَجْهَهُ عَنِ النَّارِ سَبْعِينَ خَرِيفًا. Whoever fasts one day for the sake of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make his face away from the hellfire as far as 70 years apart. Just for fasting one day. So subhanAllah, try to fast as much as you can in Sha'ban inshaAllah, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from you. Tip number 6 is dua. My dear brother, my dear sister, do you have a list of du'as that you're planning to make during Ramadan this year? Do you need something from Allah? Do you want something from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or do you just complain about your situation and you never use the great weapon that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave every believer, which is dua? Tip number 7 is sadaqah. Yes, inshallah, during Ramadan, you're going to give out a lot of sadaqah. But start practicing from now so that you're used to the idea that you need to take that money out of your pocket, take that money out of your bank account, and spend it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number 8 is parents. My dear brothers and sisters, if you want to go in Ramadan this year and you're not being good to your parents, and not only good, but being great to your parents, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And be great to your parents. Not only good to your parents, but treat your parents with greatness. This is Islam, my dear brothers and sisters. Tip number 9 is da'wah. Da'wah, my dear brothers and sisters, inviting people to the way of Allah. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي. Say, this is my way. I invite and call onto people to Allah with knowledge, me and those who follow me. See, this ayah, my dear brothers and sisters, made da'wah a faridah, made da'wah an obligation on every Muslim, each of us in our own capacity. So what you can do is try to help at least one person come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this Ramadan. And you have to start by, you know, telling them from now that inshallah we can do this, and try to invite them and try to send them links of Islamic lectures or of Quran or of other things so that they can come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now the last tip, tip number 10, is not a tip that I'm going to say. It's a tip for you to say. See, if I say tip number 10, then we're only going to have one tip number 10. But if all of you who are watching this video put for us a tip, then we'll have many number 10 tips. Okay, I hope it makes sense. So inshallah, go ahead and post a tip on Facebook or on this video on YouTube, and inshallah everybody who watches this video will see it and will benefit from it. Instead of having one number 10 tip, we'll have many number 10 tips inshallah. Finally, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this message of benefit to myself and to all of you inshallah, and to make Ramadan this year inshallah the most beneficial and the most fruitful Ramadan to have ever passed in our lives. Jazakumullahu khayran, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.